If I were living in 1999, I would have had no idea about promises and async await in JavaScript. So back in 1999, callbacks were introduced in Ecmascript and 3 to handle asynchronous operations. So what are asynchronous operations? Asynchronous operations are tasks that take some time to finish, such as fetching data from server, sending emails or uploading files. Okay, so these callbacks are functions that pass as parameter to a function, and they generally form this deeply nested structure. Now the problem with this structure is that as you move from top to bottom, it becomes really hard to understand the code, and this weird fancy looking structure even given a name, generally referred to as callback hell or pyramid of doom. Okay, so to overcome this problem, promises were introduced in ECMAScript 6 in 2015. Don't worry about all these terms, we'll learn them in detail as we proceed through this video. So they provide a way to handle asynchronous code that is more readable and easier to use. A promise is created using promise constructor, and it has three states: pending, fulfilled, or rejected. So once a promise is created, then we use a chain of dot, then, and catch to handle the fulfillment and rejection of a promise. Okay, that's fine, but I'm still not convinced because my code still looking slightly weird because of this chain of dot, then, and catch. So in 2017, async await was introduced in JavaScript. Now async await was introduced to make code look like synchronous like code. The async keyword is used to create a function that returns a promise. Inside this function, we use await keyword. Now my code looking like synchronous like code. That's cool, isn't it?